What is going on, everybody? Welcome back. MTG here with another episode. If you're new to the channel, hi there. Today in this video, I'm going to be unboxing the iPhone 13 Pro Max in Sierra Blue. This is 128 gigs. And here it is. This is the box. I also do have the iPhone 13 mini. That is going to be a separate video, as well as the iPad mini. That's also a separate video. But wait, there's more. I got a bunch of cases from ESR. Thank you to the folks at ESR for sending these out to check out. They sent out a bunch of cases, a bunch of wireless chargers for me to unbox and share with you guys, as well as something else that they wanted me to share with you guys, but that's also for a different video. So be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already to catch up on the latest videos with all these unboxings and first impressions. But without further delay, let's dive right into the unboxing and first impressions of the iPhone 13 Pro Max. So, first of all, first impressions, this is a pretty heavy box. I think the phone itself is super heavy, as obviously from what I heard too. And also the box is super thin. It doesn't come with the wall adapter anymore. That's okay. I mean, like I said in my iPhone 13 video, I use more so MagSafe nowadays to charge my iPhone. But it doesn't have that plastic wrapper. I kind of missed that. That was like a really satisfying feeling, but we have these right here. These peels are kind of like embedded into the box itself, but here we go. We're going to peel that off. And let's peel the second one off as well. Here, let's do this. There we go. There is the iPhone 13 Pro Max. And let's see my first impressions when I move this. Oh my goodness. Wow. 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 That is a huge phone. Like, this is ginormous. And the power button placement's not bad. Not bad. That camera lens is just, it's huge. Like, look at that compared to the iPhone 12 mini. And I want to compare it with my Galaxy Z Flip 3. Here it is. There's my Galaxy Z Flip 3. So this is a ginormous phone. Like, all things aside, this is a huge, huge phone. The camera lenses, obviously, sensors are much bigger, but there's a huge cutout right there. But otherwise, this Sierra Blue is a really, really nice, I think it's like a sky blue. But I really do like it much better than I do with the 12 mini. The 12 Pro Max came in a Pacific blue, in a darker blue that I also really did. I like that color too. But this 13 Pro Max in Sierra Blue, I also do like. Now, it's not what we heard according to rumors and leaks, and which is sometimes better to stay away from those because they kind of get you hyped up. And then when it doesn't happen, you get upset. But this is a new color. They don't have that bronze color for the 13 Pro. And they don't have like that orange color for like the 13. This is the new color for the 13 Pro and 13 Pro Max, but I really do like it. I like the fact that the back is this matte finish, and I don't really like the fact that the sides are stainless steel. It's because there's so many fingerprints. Like, look at that. There's so many fingerprints. I barely even, you know, held this phone, and there's so many. Whereas the iPhone 12 mini, it's aluminum sides, so as well as the 13 and 13 mini aluminum sides, and you can tell obviously fingerprints all over. A glass back, which I kind of wish it was like a matte all around, matte railings as well as a matte back to it. Obviously this is glass, this is also MagSafe wireless charging compatible. But let's get to the most satisfying part of an unboxing or peeling of this. I wish it had plastic, but it does not. But let's see how satisfying it really is. There we go. There is the iPhone 13 Pro Max in its full glory. Now, putting that aside, we have the paperwork, which comes with the SIM ejector tool, some obviously paperwork. Then the Apple sticker, I wish it was color-coded according to the iPhone color you get, but oh well, maybe next year. And also we have the USB-C or the Lightning to USB-C and no wall adapter. I don't mind. Like I said, MagSafe is the way to go for me. But let's essentially get this 13 Pro Max booted up and take a look. I can tell that the notch right here is smaller when I compare it to my 12 mini, but it's also just a little bit vertically longer. So there we go. There's the new iOS 15 Hello boot up. So let's get this device started and I'll catch you guys right back. All right, so here we go. Here is the iPhone 13 Pro Max in its full glory. Now, first impressions when I was setting up this phone, you can 100% tell right away that this has that 120 hertz ProMotion display. And obviously Android devices have had it for a couple of years now, but man, finally bringing it to the iPhone, only on the Pro and Pro Max model, you can tell, and it is a variable refresh rate. So when you're sending like a, reading a text message or what, doing something that doesn't require using the screen, it's going to drop to at the very least 10 hertz. And it can go up to, if you're playing games, for example, 120 hertz. But right now scrolling, you can tell that it has that fast refresh rate. And finally, I'm loving it. And for those who do upgrade to the newer iPhone and are coming from an older iPhone model, you're going to notice the difference right away. If you pick up, like I said, the 13 or 13 mini, you won't have that 120 hertz ProMotion. That's kind of what this year's models between the 13, the pros and the non-pros, there's more of a differentiating factor or factors. There's a bunch of features now on the pro versions that truly make it pro. Now, a lot of that's been hyped with the iPhone 13 series has been the camera. And granted, just look at that sensor. That is huge. It's ginormous, but for it's all for good cause. It's got a great camera. Well, at least on my own use, I don't know yet. But from watching videos and reviews, it's been looking great. Okay, so let's go ahead and try cinematic video. So pretty much it's kind of like a portrait video mode, but Apple's calling it cinematic. So right now it actually is able to detect this and blur the background of the plant. But I guess a lot of people are going to be using it for people. And also I do want to try out the macro mode, macro photography, which is only on the 13 Pro and Pro Max. I don't believe it's on the 13 and 13 mini, but let's get super close. I guess it automatically turns on. You can disable that in the settings, but actually, you know what? Let's try a different box. Let's go with the iPhone 12, 13 mini box and see how that turns out. I mean, looking at that, it processes it and there we go. Wow, that's pretty crisp. I believe you can get up to like maybe 2 centimeters. I could be mistaken. Let me know in the comments below. But macro photography is on this as well. Super excited to use this. This camera is going to be great. I'm going to push it to its limits. But that's really been it for this first impressions. I like this phone. I like its nice, big, beefy battery. It's going to hold up really well. This color is awesome. Some people may disagree. That's okay. We all have our own opinions. That's what makes us unique. But if you did enjoy this unboxing and first impressions, I'd really appreciate if you can give this video a thumbs up and turn on the bell notifications, as it does help out the YouTube algorithm, I can't even speak, and will help push my content out to more people. Guys, this has been, thank you. I'm going to thank you guys like in every single video of mine, because you guys make my dream become a reality. This is would not have been possible if it weren't for everyone's support, liking this video, watching it, sharing, commenting, subscribing. It really does mean a lot. And from the bottom of my heart, thank you all so much. That's been it for me, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Anyway, everybody, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to superman that like button, comment down below, because with the more interactions we get on this video, not only helps the video and the channel, but also pushes the video out to more viewers. And best of all,
Superman that subscribe button. Until next time, everybody, and until next video, this is MTG.